Hello, this is Mr. Buffington, and we are going to talk about some number properties today. And when we're talking about number properties, we can't forget about the order of operations. So we'll talk just briefly about that. But let's go right into it. What to expect? We're going to talk about the commutative property, the associative property, and the distributive property. By the end of today's lesson, you will know what those are, and you'll have seen some examples for each. The commutative property. I think about this as commuting means to move. All right, so if you're moving something, like your dad or your mom might commute to work, right? They might take the train or the bus or they might drive a car, but they're commuting to work. They're moving from one place to another. And that's a way for me to remember the commutative property. It can only be used with addition and multiplication. That's very important. And I'll show you some examples of those. Here's a basic math addition problem. 4 plus 2 is 6. And to show this visually, that 4 plus 2 equals 6 and 2 plus 4 equals 6, that's an example of the commutative property. It doesn't matter where the 4 is on the left of the plus sign or the right of the plus sign. It doesn't matter where the 2 is. When you're adding numbers, you can add them in any order and you still get the same amount. We understand that with a visual here. We can see that 4 and 2 will always give you 6 whether you switch the numbers around or not. That is the commutative property. With multiplication, we could say it like this. Four groups of two is the same thing as two groups of four. So, in other words, four times two is the same thing as two times four. They'll both give you eight. This is the commutative property. All right, when you move numbers back and forth, you can use it with addition and multiplication, and that's basically it. Now, you might say to me, Mr. Buffington, I realize that. That's pretty straightforward. Why would I ever commute a number? Why commutative numbers, right? Why would I use the commutative property with numbers? Because it's sometimes easier when you're trying to group them together. So let's take a look. Here's a question. 3 plus 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 7. When I'm adding large strings of numbers like that, I tend to group them according to what will give me groups of 10. So I would take those same numbers and put my 3 and 7 together, my 8 and 2 together, and leave the 4 off to the side. And the reason I would do that is because 3 plus 7 is 10, and then 10 and 18 is, or 10 and 8 is 18, 18 and 2 would give me my 20, and I'm left with 24. To me, that's easier to group together in groups of 10 than it would be to say 3 plus 8 is 11, plus 4 is 15, 15 plus 2 is 17, 17 plus 2 is 24. You can still do them in the order they're written. It's just, this is a nice thing to tell us we can move numbers around when we're adding them. All right. Let's look at our next property. This is the associative property. The associative property is grouping things together. Think about like the people you associate with. That's like the associative property. When you're grouped together, you're associated together. Again, it's only addition and multiplication, and it requires grouping symbols. This is one of the biggest things that is a giveaway. If it's an addition problem with grouping symbols, you know it's the associative property. If it's an addition question where the pieces move, it's the commutative property because they commute. All right? So when you get questions about whether it's associative or commutative, this is the key. Associative property will use grouping symbols. Let me show you an example. So if I have 4 plus 3 plus 1 equals 8, I can group them like that, or I could group them like that, and it doesn't matter. It will still give you 8. Now, I realize looking at this, you're like, yeah, there's 8 dots. And you move the parentheses from the first two numbers over to the second, the numbers 2 and 3 when you're adding. And it's still the same number of dots. And the reason I'm showing you that is because it's a visual way of showing what the associative property is. It works with addition and it works with multiplication. Here's an example of multiplication. We have 4 times 2 times 5. If it's written this way, we would do 4 times 2, which is 8, and then 8 times 5, which gives us 40. If we move the parentheses over to there, we would do the multiplication of 2 times 5 first, and then 4 times 10, giving us 40. So that is an example of showing that the associative property works. You can move parentheses, or in other words, you can multiply in a different order if it's all multiplication questions. If it's all addition, or if it's all multiplication, you can do this. Why would we do that? There's a big question. All right, Mr. Buffington, you've shown me that I can do it. Now, why on earth would I want to? So let's go ahead and take a look at that. It's sometimes easier to move things. Look at this. I have 6 plus 5 plus 5 plus 9 plus 1. So I would have to do some pretty complicated, not super complicated, but I have to do 6 and 5 is 11, 5 and 9 is 14, 11 and 14 and 1. It seems kind of complicated. Instead, I can move those grouping symbols and again group together some things that are easier to add. 5 and 5 is 10, 9 and 1 is 10. You see? Boom! 10 and 10. Don't know why I repeated that line, but that's okay. All right, so I have 10 and 10, and that makes my adding easier. That's why we use the associative property. This is a practical way that we would use the associative property. That's what it's for. All right, so we've talked about the commutative property when you actually move the numbers back and forth, the associative property when the numbers stay in the same order and you move the grouping symbols around. Now, those two are often confused with each other. This third one is totally different. This is the distributive property. And the distributive property says the numbers outside the parentheses gets distributed to everything inside the parentheses. And by distributed, I just use that word so that we could have a good reason to call it the distributive property, I guess. But it means that it's multiplied. Everything outside the parentheses gets multiplied times everything inside the parentheses. All right? That's pretty much it. There's absolutely no need for this fourth oval at all. All right, so let's go ahead and see the distributive property in action. Here it is. 3 times 1 plus 2. Now, the way that we've done this in the past is that we solve what's inside the parentheses. 1 plus 2 is 3. And then those parentheses imply multiplication, so we do 3 times 3, which gives us 9. The way that we would use the distributive property is that instead of going from doing what's inside the parentheses first, we would multiply what's outside the parentheses, the 3, times 1 and times 2. So 3 times 1 is 3, and 3 times 2 is 6, and then we'd have 3 plus 6, which gives us 9. Now, you can see that you'll end up with the same exact answer. That means that this is true, it works, okay? So the distributive property does work. Now, the big question. Why would I ever use the distributive property? And I'm going to tell you that I can see into your future. I'm no Marty McFly or anything, but I'm going to see into your future here. And it's not any easier now. Okay? It's not any easier to use the distributive property now, but you'll need it for later on. So it's a good thing to know about. It's a mistake that is often made when people don't know that you have to multiply that first number times everything inside the parentheses. And it will become a helpful tool later on. Right now, looking at it might not seem helpful, but trust me, you'll use it in the future. All right. Now, to change gears just a little bit, I want to give you a quick reminder of the order of operations. You need to follow the order of operations. These addition and multiplication properties don't remove the need for order of operations. Okay, so we still do what's inside the parentheses. We still solve multiplication and division before we do addition, subtraction. So all the questions that you'll solve using these properties will also follow the order of operations. So please, don't forget what we've done in the past just because we've learned something new. It still follows this order of operations. All right, so just a quick recap of what we've gone over. 1, commutative property, you can move the numbers back and forth. 2, associative property, leave the numbers in the same order, move the grouping symbols. 3, distributive property, take what's outside the parentheses and you multiply it times each term inside of the parentheses. Hope that was helpful for you. Have a wonderful day.